Long before Lady Liberty graced New York Harbor, its waters teemed with oysters, sustaining generations of Native Americans.
Guys, let's get the next cabinet out in the water.
Scientists, along with volunteers, are now attempting to return New York's waterways to their former glory as part of the Billion Oyster Project.
In the 1600s, it was tough to navigate the waters because there were so many oyster reefs, over 220,000 acres. So this is a project that is native to New York's history.
This site in Brooklyn is one of 11 where the project is attempting to recreate reefs with shells collected from local restaurants and baby oysters, some from farms on the East Coast, others grown at a local school with the help of students.
By 1906, New Yorkers had eaten every last oyster. Their reefs had been dredged up or covered in silt, and the water quality was too poor for their regeneration. It stayed that way until 1972, in the passage of the Clean Water Act, which prohibited dumping sewage and waste into the harbor.
Even now, the waters aren't clean enough to eat what lives there, but the oyster reefs have huge benefits for the local ecosystem.
So our oysters, I like to call them little superheroes. They're tiny, but they pack a punch. And they provide such habitat for the biodiversity of New York Harbor.
Nicholas Jacobson helped make the metal cages that create the reefs and volunteered to help place them in the water. The oysters slide in like a file cabinet.
So in the city, there's not many options to really connect with nature. It's mostly asphalt, concrete, and steel. But this really gives an opportunity within the city to kind of connect with nature and, I guess, just give back to the environment, because we do take a lot.
And when it comes to the health of New York's waterways, cultivating that connection may be just as important as cultivating oysters. Kristen Salumi, Al Jazeera, Brooklyn, New York.